It's the Coffee King here, and I know that I've been on, you know, I posted two videos today on Facebook and here on YouTube, but I figured I'd just go ahead and knock out another review for everybody. This is something different. You guys remember my 12 Days of Christmas, right? Well, there's another package that I seen and that I just got. And this is just called, you know, the coffee gift box, okay? I mean, it's Christmassy, so I'm guessing it's like the 12 days of Christmas. There's 12 K-Cups in here, different flavors. Now, some of these I have reviewed before. Like, I believe the Maple Sleigh, Butterscotch Swirl, the Sella's, Andy's, Jingle Java. I believe I did those. But there's some in here that I have not tried. So the ones, we're just going to do this. We're just going to do this whole box. You know, we're going to go 12 days. And hopefully all these are good. If I remember some of these and some of this was good. So the first one that I'm going to start with, by the way, here it is, guys. Here it is. 12 Days of Christmas. This is just a gift set box, so. The one in here that stood out to me the most, I'm going to go ahead and do right now. And that is Brooklyn Bean Roastery red velvet flavored coffee. There it is. Hopefully this is going to be good, because you guys already know. I'm going to tell you exactly what it is when it comes to this coffee. So, let's get right into it. Alright guys, while that coffee is brewing, I'm going to need every single one of you to make sure that if you're on my YouTube side of the world, subscribe to my channel, hit that bell icon so you guys don't miss any videos. Also, like them, comment on them, it's greatly appreciated. And same thing goes if you're on my Facebook side of the world. Make sure that you guys are either liking or following my page. Turn on them live notifications so you guys don't miss an update or if I decide to go live. Like my videos, comment on them, share them. It's greatly appreciated. I know the coffee's still brewing, so just going to talk about some random stuff. So the last few months I've been on a firearm addiction. I'm not going to lie, dude. I bought my first firearm a few months ago. Actually, it was a couple months ago. And I'm addicted to buying guns now. Like, obviously, it's legit. I have to do it all legit, so get them all registered in my name and everything. But the first gun that I got was a CZ P10C 9mm. And it's a really, really nice handgun, guys. As you guys can see back in the corner, I got it on the desk. It's in a case. It holds 17 rounds plus one. Then I got the old school. I think that's a Springfield 87 model rifle. It's got the bolt action semi-automatic. I believe it's the first long barrel automatic rifle. I'm not sure because it's really old and I got that off of a friend, which, you know, I haven't shot it or anything like that. It's just, it's old. But the pistol is in my name. And here soon, here in the next couple weeks, I'm going to be getting a hold of a shotgun. And hopefully, man, people are flying down this road. Hopefully they got some of the Mossberg Mavericks available because I'm really interested in getting the Mossberg Maverick. And then after that, I'll be getting another rifle. I'm addicted to buying guns now, guys. And I know that now is a good time to be getting, your gun stock up. And your ammo. Don't forget about that. But anyways, coffee is done. Red Velvet Brooklyn Bean Roastery is done. Let's get into it. All right, so here we are. I got the Brooklyn Bean Roastery Red Velvet Flavored Coffee. No cream, no sugar. And right off the top, guys, it really does smell like red velvet. If you guys haven't had the cake, It literally smells just like this. With a hint of popcorn. Man, why am I getting that with all these, like, 12 Days of Christmas coffees, man? Why do I get that? It's weird. But anyways, here we are. No cream, no sugar. Brooklyn Bean Roastery Red Velvet. Let's go, baby. Part one of the review, by the way. Ooh. That is nice. You get a hint of the red velvet icing. That I'm just saying, like, the icing that comes on a red velvet cake, you get a hint of that. This is a very rich coffee, by the way, and I'm not talking about sweetness. I'm talking about the roast of the coffee. The notes of the richness in this coffee is insane, guys. It's got a hint, not a hint, but a slight bitterness to it, but it goes down really smooth. And like I said, you get a hint of the icing from the red velvet cake. Yeah, this is a real good cup of coffee. Hold on a second, guys. Watch my camera. Some random dude going off on his chick walking right now. Hold on. I'm just making sure he don't do anything stupid. You know what I'm saying? Alright. So back to this coffee. They're gone now. Like I said, it's got the slight bitterness to it. You can taste the icing from the red velvet cake. It's a hint of that. It goes down smooth. Rich notes in this coffee. Right back to the Christmas days, baby. Right back to the Christmas days is where this brings me. If you guys enjoy your Christmas, I suggest you guys to give this a try. The Red Velvet by Brooklyn Bean Roastery. This is without the cream and sugar, and it's a 5 out of 5 all day. 5 out of 5 without the cream and sugar, guys. This is, like I said, this is just the part one of the review. Part one. Sorry, I got a little sidetracked there, man. People were getting more crazy by the day out here. So that's also why it's very important to stock up on your guns and ammo, guys. It's our right to do that. Make sure that you guys do that. If you have felonies and all that, you might as well forget about it. But now is the time to do it. All right, 5 out of 5 without the cream and sugar. Let's go ahead and add some cream and sugar to it. See if it helps it. Or see if it dumbs it down. Let's go. This is hot. Burning my fingers through the cup. But anyways, here we are with the Brooklyn Bean Roastery Red Velvet flavored coffee with a little bit of that sugar booger and some half and half, baby. You already know how we do. Part two of this review. Here we go. Okay, so the red velvet flavor. Right off the top, guys. Right off the top, the red velvet flavor is coming out more strong. That's what happens to some of these coffees whenever you add half and half and sugar to it. You still get a hint of the bitterness. The icing from the red velvet cake flavor is still there. The actual cake from the red velvet is coming out. Still got the rich notes to it, just from the roast of the coffee. I could definitely taste that still. And then the cream and sugar bring it all together, giving it a little bit more of sweetness that you desire. All around a fantastic cup of coffee. Like I said, this is the type of coffee that you drink during the Christmas time, during the holidays. I mean, right now, it's snowy outside. We got about 8-9 inches of snow out there right now. That's minus the snow that's already been melted. So 8-9 inches of snow out there. It's really cold. So why not have a cup of coffee that reminds you of Christmas? Icicles hanging from the house and stuff. I can see right here on the cameras. 5 out of 5, man. Heavy 5 out of 5 for this cup of coffee with the cream and sugar, guys. Mm-mm. So delicious. Anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed this review. 5 out of 5 both ways. If you did, let me know in the comments. Make sure that you guys are liking my videos and commenting on them, man. Like I said, it's greatly appreciated. You guys are supporting the Coffee King. And the Coffee King, you know, really, really appreciates it. So, enjoy the rest of your guys' night or the rest of your day. Remember to love one another, be there for one another, and be more positive. Find God and learn to love yourself more. It's very important that you do that. Wake up every day, look into the mirror, and tell yourself that you love yourself. You got to love yourself before anything else. Before anyone else, you got to love yourself. Remember that, guys. Be great at whatever it is that you desire. I'm off of here. Until next time, guys. Much love. Peace. I'm gonna drink this coffee, man.